All right, so now we are talking about the combination of errors. We have just now introduced what will happen to errors if two measured quantities are added or subtracted. Okay, so it does not matter whether they are added or subtracted, the errors will always get added. Okay, now there are a lot of formulas in physics where you multiply the two quantities. Work done is force into displacement in the direction of force. Okay, force is equal to mass times acceleration, v is equal to u plus a into t, s equal to ut plus half a into t into t. Okay, so multiplication is a common thing in physics. So we should also know what will happen to error if you multiply the two quantities which themselves have the errors. Okay, so write down multiplication of errors. Multiplication or division, both you write. Multiplication and division. Now, suppose you have this formula. Y is equal to... Achha, by the way, whenever we have deriving the equation or formula for the error, we just use A and B. Sum A and B. It could be A plus B plus C. Then also errors of A and errors of B and C will get added up. So it can go on till whatever number of quantities you are adding. Okay. Similarly, product also. I am just multiplying two quantities. It can be a multiplication of three quantities or four quantities. Okay. So whatever formula that comes out is applicable of any number of quantities getting multiplied. Okay. So let's say Y is equal to A into B. Okay. Can you similarly, the way you have derived the previous one, can you derive what will happen to the error in Y? Substitute A as A mean plus minus delta A mean, B as B mean plus minus delta B mean, and Y as Y mean plus minus delta Y mean. Put it and try to simplify it. Okay, derived. Okay, so Y mean plus minus delta Y mean will be equal to what? Multiplication of A mean plus minus delta A mean with B mean plus minus delta B mean. Just open the brackets. Okay, so this will come out to be A mean B mean plus minus A mean delta B mean plus minus B mean delta A mean Okay, so this is Y mean plus minus delta Y mean. Getting it? Now I can say that Y mean is equal to A mean into B mean. So delta Y mean is the rest of the expression.
So it's A mean into B mean plus delta B mean plus...
Wait. This is equal to A mean delta B mean plus B mean. I am trying to find the maximum possible error. All will get added like this. Okay. Now, usually whenever you measure anything, the errors are less. As in less than the measured quantity. Yes or no? If doesn't make sense to have error which is more than the measured quantity. You measure 5 cm and your error is 10 cm, something is wrong with you. Okay. So the error is much less than the measured quantity. Okay, so that's why delta AM into delta BM will be very less compared to these two quantities. Yes or no? Right? So you can ignore this. Alright? If you ignore it, all of you write it again without this expression like this. Because the errors are much less compared to the AM and BM. Multiplication of error is much less compared to multiplication of reading with error.
So, but you're supposed to have the maximum possibility, right?
It should represent maximum. But we like to have a better looking expression as a formula. Okay, but if you want to be very very accurate, you want to be very very precise, or you want to be very sure about it, you add that also. Okay, but in our syllabus, the way we are deriving it, we are ignoring it because it tends to be very less. Okay, now can you see a pattern over here? Can you do something and try to write error in a better manner? Or you can leave it like this. What can you say? Can you say that the error in the reading of Y is a sum of the errors? You can't say that. Yes or no? Because it is AM into delta APM. It is not delta BM plus delta AM. Okay, so what can I say? Suppose I have to explain what will happen to the error if you multiply. Suppose you divide by AM into BM. All of you do this.
Or you add the...
Okay, then AM into BM is delta Y. Sorry, Y. So I can say that delta Y by Y is equal to delta A by A plus delta B by B. Yes or no?
So that's YM. Delta Y by Y.
Yeah, YM is the actual value. So if I just write Y, it means actual value. Understood? So the correct way of saying is that if the two quantities are multiplied, their relative errors will get added up. Yes or no?
Yeah.
If they are add, if the quantities are added, their absolute error gets added up. If they are multiplied, their relative error gets added up. Okay? Same can be proved for the division as well.
It will be the same.
If Y is equal to A by B, can you prove similarly?
Yeah.
Now you said yes. Do it. If Y is equal to A by B, what happens to the error? I hope you have little bit idea about binomial approximation. Binomial approximation is something which you will be using again and again. So get familiar with it. This is what it is. 1 plus X raised to power Y is equal to 1 plus xy. This is approximate value if mod of x is very less than 1. So if x is like 0.0001 or 0.0 minus of 0.001, then you can approximate this as that. Doesn't matter the sign of y. It could be negative or positive both. It could be fraction also. Understood? So use this while deriving. It's a common approximation. You can, you know, check also here. Suppose it is 1 plus 0.01 whole square. If you do this, I am saying that this is roughly equal to 1 plus 2 into 0.01. Does it make sense? A square plus B square. B square is very less.
Yeah.
Plus 2AB, which is 2 into 0.01. Okay. Similarly, there is an expansion of 1 plus, let's say, 0.01 raised to power 3. This will also be equal to roughly 1 plus 3 into 0.01. There will be square or cube terms of 0.01 in further expansion. Okay? So, probably you are seeing it for the first time, but this we are going to use again and again in entire physics. So, get comfortable with it.
There's a way to do it.
You said yeah, right?
I didn't think it through. Bad decision.
So YM plus delta YM is equal to
multiply
A
with BM plus minus delta BM to the power minus 1.
Yeah.
Then
yes.
Delta BM becomes.
Delta
okay, yeah.
Very nice.
That one works.
Power minus 1. Understood. Now, if I take BM outside, it will become AM plus minus delta AM. Then I take if BM outside, it will become 1 plus minus delta BM by BM raised to power minus 1. Then this delta BM by BM is very less than 1. So I can take minus 1 inside. And if minus 1 comes inside with plus and minus, it remains plus and minus itself. So this thing will become AM plus minus delta AM multiplied with BM 1 plus minus delta BM by BM, which again is same. AM plus minus delta AM. Achha, BM ratio power minus 1 will be there, by the way. Okay, you're taking BM outside. BM ratio power minus 1 will be there. This divided by BM 1 plus minus delta BM by BM. Okay? Now when you simplify it further, same thing you'll get. Absolute errors will get added up. AM by BM is?
YM.
Okay? Yeah. So like that you can do this. Okay, so write down, in case of division also, relative errors get added up. Case of division also, the relative error get added up. Okay, tell me what will happen to this. If y is equal to a cube, then what will happen? It's multiplication of a three times. So relative error in y, delta y by y is equal to delta a by a plus delta a by a plus delta a by a. Okay, so it becomes 3 times delta a by a. Okay, so this exponent will come in front. Okay, we have proved it for integers, but even if it is a fraction, then also it comes front. For example, if you have this expression, y is equal to b raised to power 3 by 2, delta y by y will be what? 3 by 2 times delta b by b. Remember these things.
But this can only be for a constant, right?
What constant?
The power should be...
Power should be a constant. It can be any real number. Okay?
So what if you had y is equal to a to the power b?
There's a different method to deal with it. But in our curriculum, we are only dealing with addition, subtraction, division, multiplication, and the exponents, which are constant. Okay? There are ways. I mean, I'll be talking about it in some time. Right now, please focus here. Okay. Can you quickly write for this? What if y is equal to a cube b raised to power 3 by 2 divided by c raised to power 7 by 2? Quickly write down, what is the error in y? What it will be? Delta y by y will be equal to 3 times delta a by a plus 3 by 2
delta b by
b by b
minus 7 by 2.
No, sir, plus 7
plus
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 plus 7 by
2. Even if it is divided,
yeah,
the errors get added up. Sometimes it happens that you have to bring whatever is error on the right hand side, you have to take it on the left hand side. Then also you should this plus, if suppose this error I have to move it to the left hand side, it remains plus only. If you give go there, it will add up here. Errors never get subtracted. You write it in bolds. You will never subtract error.